What's going on, everybody? So in today's video, we're going to be doing from the House of Creed, a fragrance that came out last year in 2017, and we're going to be doing Creed's Viking. So this decant I ended up getting from my good friend Jordan, so I'm going to see if I can attach Jordan's link down below. So if you're from Canada and you're interested in some decants. So Creed's Viking was actually launched last year in 2017. The classification, I'm not exactly sure, but I would probably have to say it's more of a woody aromatic of some kind. Because I only have a decant, let's see a picture as to what the bottle looks like, and then let's dive into this one. The top notes of this one are pink pepper, Calabrian bergamot, and Sicilian lemon, with the mid being, again, pink pepper, according to Fragrantica, Bulgarian rose, and mint, with the base being sandalwood, vetiver, patchouli, and lavender. The notes that I get out of this that I get loads of pink pepper with a lot of mint. Now, in the opening, this really does come across as like a campfire. But I also get a bit of a menthol vibe, if you will. Maybe it's the combination of those two particular notes, the pink pepper and the mint, but I get a menthol-y type of vibe with a campfire, like a smoky campfire feel. I also get a little bit of the citruses, and the base is pretty much just an earthy vetiver. This fragrance does come across as very masculine, it's bold, it's a little bit deep, it's warm. It's a very woody, masculine type of scent. Like, this is pretty much what I would picture an alpha male wearing. When it comes to all the Creed fragrances that I smelled now, this is probably one of the more masculine out there. I find that with a lot of the fragrance offerings, a lot of them can actually be unisex. Like, even though Aventus for her is considered a female fragrance, that one's very unisex. Original Santal is unisex. Creed Royal Mayfair, that is definitely not masculine to my nose. The Royal Oud I have yet to smell, but this one here is by far the most masculine Creed that I have smelled. Occasions to wear this one, this is more of a night out type of fragrance. Semi-formal, formal. This is a very classy fragrance that you can wear to a very formal setting. You can also wear it to work. And when I picture someone wearing this to work, I picture more of a CEO, a supervisor, a boss. Someone that's higher up the food chain or the corporate ladder. This fragrance really is a different type of fragrance when it comes to Creed. Seasons to wear this, fall and winter, longevity, great, 10 plus hours, and the projection was light to moderate. Prices on this one. Now this is where it gets a little interesting, and I think that this is where the hate for Creed Viking begins. At the Creed Boutique, for a 50 and a 100 ml, you're looking to spend between $355 and $395 USD. That's a bit of a price tag, if you will. Online, you can get this about $200 to $315 USD. Even if you are to get the 100 ml online, you're still paying a pretty penny, but is it worth $315? I personally do not think so. I do like this fragrance. I think that the hate that it got, this was a new release that came out in 2017, and that was the first release in 7 years. The last release before that was Creed Aventus, and Creed Aventus to a lot of people is the holy grail of fragrances. You know, nothing compares to Aventus. But I think that because it's Creed and it's a new release, that the hype that this generated was its downfall. A lot of people were probably hoping that for another version of a Creed Aventus. I'm not too sure, but I think that the hype that this really generated left a lot of people disappointed, along with the price tag, of course, because I really don't think that this is worth the money. You know, it's really not worth that 400 USD, give or take. And I know that Creed is a niche market for people who are not afraid to spend money. It's for people who have that coin to spend. My wife's thoughts on this one? Well, she does like it. She says it's mature, manly, and she gets a very smoky, woody vibe as well. And my final thoughts, based on smell itself and the versatility, 3.5 out of 5. I do like the smell of this one. I think it's a great, bold, masculine, signature scent worthy scent for someone who does have that coin, who is not afraid of spending that money. After this, I'm definitely not going to get another decant. It's not a forgettable scent. I do like it. But for me, it's not really worth getting, all right? So again, I do like it. It really got a lot of hype, but it certainly wasn't worth the hate that it got. And I hope that Creed does come out with another release in the next few years. Maybe something a little bit different. I think that probably the most unique fragrance that I've smelled was their Creed Royal Mayfair. That one was certainly not for me. So guys, that's it for Creed Viking. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Share the video, subscribe if you haven't. Hit that notification bell. Thank you for your time, take care, and we'll see you later.